Okay, now this should be good. This is the F4 Phantom. It's stored away, and I just thought I'd take it for a blast, see how we get on. See if I can get me in the shot as well. Hopefully we can. Following free movement. One stage of flaps. Brakes off. Holding on the brakes. Power going up. Brakes off. Come on, keep it straight. Speed building. RPM's good. Engines are good. Back pressure. And we are airborne. Gear. Oh, what's happened to the weather? The weather's not good shit. Flaps up. Full power. Awesome. Tell you what, the F4 was a good aeroplane, you know, it really was. It's a bit scary to fly. Right, 1090. Let's see out of the sky. Let's go south. Okay, so those three islands up there, that's the Minches. I'm going to head for them and then do 180, and that will take me directly to the Isle of Skye. Not seeing my three islands. For some reason the visibility to the south is really nice. Doesn't take long to get anywhere in the F4. Super cool. So what do I think of this model? It looks very similar to X-Plane 11, actually. Maybe marginally better. Going into rain. Scenery, of course, is nowhere near as good as Orbex. Okay, new 180. That will take me to the Isle of. There it is. So nearly about 600. Altitude 2,000 feet. 600 mile an hour in the rain. Oh yes. Slow down a bit. there's Flora MacDonald down there. Right there. Who? You can Google her. Right. And we are heading down to Portree. We've got the ferry from here to Stornoway. Apparently, it's a full egg or something. Can't remember. So we'll probably go back to Lossiemouth, I think. A nice long runway for this, and we have to deploy the parachute in order to stop. So it comes in at around 200, just under 200 knots. So it's horrendously fast. Imagine touching down on an aircraft carrier at almost 200 knots. That'd be super scary, wouldn't it? But well, it would for me. We should have Portree here on the nose, somewhere. Got off past Kingston down there. See a little port go whizzing past underneath. That is Portree. Where's the harbour? Just to my left slightly, but now it's right underneath. Here we go. So we'll go overhead Broadford, I think, and then we'll route east. That's a loss enough. Right on the by road getting around these islands. The weather will be better on the east side. These are the western islands. Okay. Should tell Broadford we're coming now, in case we've got any traffic. There's a bad idea. F4 thundering through. 400 knots. Coastline here. I guess that's it right there. Not really, it's changed. It's changed a lot. Bridge to the Alaskan. Plopped into another airfield, should be on the nose here, somewhere. Not seeing it. This has got to be it up ahead. Far too small to land this there. But there we are. That's the airfield there. Right for a helicopter or a Cessna 172 or something like that. It should be Loch Carron. Must have come up the wrong lock because there's another lock there. No, I think it's this one. I don't think much of the scenery. Really. Well, I'm evaluating X-Plane 12. And so far, it's no good. It's a fob off. It really is. The only thing they've done is these water effects look quite good when it rains, you know. Now, with all those tits up, and we can't see where we're going, we're just going to have to go vertical and hit the afterburner, because these flying conditions are atrocious. We don't want to run into a hill. It's what we call cumulus granitus. You can see the tops of the hills, look. If I can remember the way to Lossiemouth, of course I can. It's a silly question. Map? I don't need a map. As long as I can see where I'm going, I don't need a map. The weather effects are definitely better with X-Plane 12. I want more realistic ground features. Nice steady 400 knots. lose visibility. Approaching Inverness now, I think. Watch the wires. Watch out for a mast. We've got masts around here. No wind. There's a bit of transmitter mast on the top of the helmet, so I'll look to my left hand. But even so, there's shifty visibility. You can take a wrong turn quite easy. I think if anything, the east coast is worse than the west coast at the moment. Should be a bridge up ahead over this water. I think I'm in the right place. There's our bridge. To be doing my visual. Those lines are really. It's a little bit tight there. That's not in the nest before then. A low pass in the nest airfield. Visibility is really pants, isn't it? I would land at Inverness, but here it is, just right underneath there. There's a runway. I'm not entirely sure the runway is long enough. Might be. Might be. Come back here if I can't get in. At Loss Enough, we've got a nice big runway as well at Kinloss, so I could even go there. It's looking worse and worse the further I go. I'll go into Kinloss. This is horrible. Wind is easterly, I think. It was. I have to get an update. I'm not getting an update. I can't afford to take my eyes off the terrain. Otherwise, I'll get lost in a second. Okay, we'll call Kinloss to them, we're coming straight into land. So, we're going to have to slow down because Kinloss isn't far ahead. Waffles are closed. Diminishing. Looking for our runway, which is up ahead. Going to land at airspeed, and airspeed every time. Okay, 250. on the nose here somewhere. Gear in transit. Flaps, you want one stage, you want two stages, more power. In my insight, and for that, it looks a little bit clearer. Holding at 200, that's good. Two stages off. That's good, Dominic, on his slot. Well, the lights up. Two reds, two green, two whites. Three reds, a bit low. A little bit slow. Keep it coming, keep it coming. Keep it coming. That's good, that's good, that's good. Okay, power down. Pilot shoot. Nice long runway. And we'll check our wind socks, see if we made the right choice of runways. Well, I see the wind sock. Haven't seen it yet. Looks like we could have carried on to Lossiemouth, but it's very important to just make a decision when you're a pilot and do it. And sometimes you don't make the right decision, but other times you do. And I think we made the right decision there to divert, because it was looking really, really shitty actually. There's the windsock over there. Yes, we landed on the right runway. We are into wind. Show me some taxi to park. It was fun, wasn't it? Do enjoy this flying, you know. Let's have a look at the outside of the aircraft. There we go. Look at that, that. Left the flaps down, look, can bring the flaps up now. The F4 Phantom. What a wicked machine. I mean, it is super scary to fly. This and the Lightning, the English Electric Lightning, they are super scary to fly. And if you've ever flown an aeroplane, you'll know why. So we shall taxi over here. I'm looking forward to, I've downloaded the Canberra B2, the X-Plane 12 version, so that's a nice plane, the one my dad used to fly, so I'm looking forward to cruising about in that, for free of course. I think we'll park up over here somewhere. Pointing into wind, there we go, that'll do, let's brakes on. Thanks for watching, everybody. Hope you enjoyed that as much as I did.